Greetings to one and all present here. We are from Team 2 and we are going to give some insights about humanoid robotics. Now I would like to call upon Kunal Khandelwal to talk about what are humanoid robotics.
Thank you, Sanskriti. Good evening, everyone. My name is Kunal Khandelwal and now I would tell you something about humanoid robots. Next slide. Now, what are humanoid robots? A humanoid robot is a robot with its body shape built to resemble the human body. In general, humanoid robots have a torso, a head, two arms, and two legs. Some humanoid robots also have heads designed to replicate human facial features such as eyes and mouth. Next. As you can see in this picture, it is a typical humanoid robot which have a head, two arms, and two legs. Now let's jump to some features of humanoid robots. Humanoid robots are especially desirable in human society as they can work well in indoor environments that have been designed for humans. The technical characteristics for humanoid robot are facial expression, walking, speaking and hearing, body gestures, and vision. Next. These characteristics are believed to be essential in every humanoid robot involved in education. The attempt to simulate the human body leads to a better understanding of it. Humanoid robots, especially those with artificial intelligent algorithms, could be useful for future dangerous and distant space exploration mission without having the need to turn back around again and return to Earth once the mission is completed. Now I would like to call Deepak to tell some advantages and disadvantages of humanoid robots.
Yes, thank you, Kunal. Hello, everyone. This is Deepak. Now I'm going to discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of the humanoid robots in the field of psychology. Okay, next slide. First of all, coming to advantages, humanoid robots communicate with humans along with communicating. They even respond through emotional face expressions. So these pictures will be shown in the further slides. Coming to the next point, Para is a robot designed by Dr. Takanri Shibata to share happiness and relaxation. There are some robots that can show their emotions, their face expressions. For example, IKEA developed by Philips Research to study aspects of robot capable of mechanically rendering facial expressions through eyebrows, eyelids, eyes, lips, and head movement. Humanoids are developed to mimic human behavior and can be used to perform human tasks. These humanoids can be used to communicate with humans who live alone. It would give them great enjoyment and relief to them. Move to the next slide. Okay, this is the image of the Paro, which I discussed in the previous slide. And the first image is of the Paro. And the second image is the situation where it shares happiness with a child in the hospital, so we can use it like this. So next slide. These are some of the expressions shown by the robot iCat, such as seriousness, happiness, and etc. Move to the next slide. So coming to this disadvantages, robots operate only when given specific instructions. Once the instructions have been provided, the robots will work. However, they cannot think on their own and therefore are not equipped to solve a crisis in case any occurs. Robots can sometimes be very dangerous if not controlled. Because of their unintelligent nature, they may cause harm to humans annoyingly. When these robots start thinking by their own, there is a chance of becoming selfish and try to eliminate humans. If we have these robots doing these everyday jobs first, we'll become too dependent on them and we'll be lazy. Okay, next slide. Finally, coming to the purpose of humanoid robots. Humanoid robots are created for entertainment purposes. Humanoid robots are now used as research tools in several scientific areas. Coming to this scientific research, nowadays several scientists are using, are replaced by these humanoid robots to do their task. Since they need to work in very toxic conditions, so their work will be done by the humanoid robots. coming to the next point, some humanoids are created to carry out specific tasks, such as the tasks of personal assistant using AI, helping out at elderly homes, and so on. Humanoids are also suitable for some procedurally based vocations, such as reception desk administrations and automotive manufacturing line workers. Next point. Humanoid robots, especially those with artificial intelligence algorithms, could be useful for future dangerous and distant space exploration machines. So with this, I'm concluding my presentation. Thank you. And the further presentation will be continued by Sanskriti Mishra.
Thank you, Deepa. Good evening. I'm Sanskriti Mishra, and I'm going to talk about some notable innovations of humanoid robots. It is often said that a human shape is useful because the robot can use the same tools and environments as a human. But one can also know about the big reason is that humans find it to be easiest to control robots in the humanoid form, explained by THR3 development leader Tomohisa Moidaria. The first robotic avatar was introduced by Toyota in 2017. Can we move to the next slide, please? Robotic avatars are something that developing true robot surrogates that allow you to be in two places at one time means duplicating all your movements and senses in the machine form. Given now you can make a video call using your phone, it is fair to say that we have the sight and sound aspects pretty well covered, but the challenge adding to the touch is formidable. Telesar V robot avatar shows just how we have come to turning into telepresence into teleexistence. It is a humanoid robot that is controlled, and it boasts a wide range of movements along with the ability to transmit sight, hearing, and touch sensations to its operators via a set of sensors and 3D head-mounted displays. Next one. Robotic ambassadors. Perhaps this is one of the most recognizable face of humanoids is Sophia, a social humanoid robot that is developed by Hong Kong-based Hansen Robotics. In 2020, this AI-powered 4-year-old robot is going to continue her role as a robotic ambassador, helping to advance research into robotics and human-robot interactions. Taught by humans, Sophia can talk and show some emotions, draw as well as think. She has appeared in many shows like The Tonight Show and Good Morning Britain, and she is the first robot to be granted as a citizenship of Saudi Arabia. Can we move to the next slide? Robot Rashmi. Back in August, news came of an indigenously developed humanoid robot called Rashmi, which was made by Ranjit Srivastava, a 38-year-old Ranchi-based software engineer. The robot was called the Indian version of Sophia, which was developed by Hansen Robotics, a Hong Kong-based company. Rashmi is said to have snagged from the title of being the first RJ robot as it started RJing from Red FM from December 3rd. The robot hosts an Ask Rashmi segment where it listens to the robot user's query and replies to them. Also, the developer Srivastava added that robot is India's first lip-syncing robot that uses artificial intelligence, linguistic interpretation, visual data, face recognition system, enabling it to act and answer queries just like human beings. And also this Russia Today reports that this robot believes in God and has a spiritual sight. It can speak in multiple languages like English, Hindi, Bhojpuri, as well as Marathi. Now I would like to call upon Iyashi Pal to give us some more insights about the challenges that is faced by the people or robots.
Thank you, Sanskriti. I am going to talk about the challenges in making humanoid robots. Next slide. Manufacturing procedures. Till date, old age hardwares like gears, motors, and actuators make robots rigid and most susceptible to damage. The solution for this problem would be developing robots that are more flexible with less joints and connecting parts. Facilitating human-robot collaborations. Cobots are robots that are designed to work with humans. Cobots must be able to understand human emotions, languages, and behavior in order to work in partnership with humans in an industrial setting. Next slide. Creating better power source. Most present day robots are highly inefficient in terms of energy consumption. These robots still rely on old age power generation and storage techniques like lithium ion and nickel metal hydride batteries, which are usually unsafe and deplete quickly. Mapping environments. Robots are unable to navigate their obstacles in the path, leading to delay in carrying out the assigned tasks or even cause accidents. Even though these robots are highly trained, they are still unable to navigate their environments. Next slide. Minimizing privacy and security risks. The data used for training robots can be misused by reprogramming or modifying it. Robots need a lot of data to perform the tasks they are designed to. The data collected by the robots, such as videos, images, and location details, can be misused if they are in the wrong hands. Developing reliable artificial intelligence. Technology cannot be trusted completely. Currently, artificial intelligence is no match for human reasoning, and thus robotic solutions aren't foolproof or completely dependable. Now I would like to invite Harsh to present the next slide.
I hope I am audible and visible.
Yes,
okay. So thank you, Yashi, for inviting me. So I, Harsh, is here to present my topic, my presentation on the topic Futuristic Advancement in Artificial Intelligence and Robotics. So let's discuss about what is AI. So before discussing what actually is AI, we need to know what is not AI. So AI is not going to conquer the world. People might worry about losing their job to more efficient and effective AI robots or machine. But remember, these people also worried at the same time when there was a first time the wheel invented and there was an industrialization period. They thought the old jobs are going to be removed and they are going to be replaced. But it was not so. Rather, the result has been more wealth and more jobs. And second, AI is not magic that can solve anything. So people believe that AI is some kind of magic that will solve anything for us. We can't hire a robot to do all sorts of tasks, and that too with human level accuracy. We still need humans and will always do. So now let's discuss about what actually is AI. AI refers to the stimulation of human intelligence in machines that are programmed to think like human and mimic their actions. So now I'm going to discuss what all entails in AI, what all corporates under the AI. Actually, it's very difficult for me to tell or for anyone to tell what actually is there in AI. But still, I have tried to present some of the important constituents of AI, and they are as follows. Machine learning. Machine learning is a computer system's ability to perform with the proper exposure to the information without the need of explicit hardcore programming. Speech recognition, this particular type of AI technology attempts to utilize text to identify text genre, sentence structure, grammar, and everything. Natural language processing. This branch of machine learning that deals with the processing of all the type of data related to text and all stuff. Speech recognition is a branch of AI that deals with the RNN, the recurrent neural network that performs all the jobs of speech. It processes a speech that is being given to it, and it processes and it stores in its short-term memory and then processes the same data. Now, image recognition, this AI technology involves recognizing patterns at pixel level by the computer systems. Now coming to robotics, a robot, it might be familiar concept to you all, but could you describe it? In robotics, scientists integrate the artificial intelligence or the artificial brain, perhaps thus creating it to perform all the sorts of human behavior and think like them and do walk like them and talk like them and do all such entities. So now here I have tried to show you some stats regarding AI in robotics, how fast the market of AI in robotics is growing. The robotics market, for instance, is growing faster than many of us would have ever expected. AI is developing even faster. It grew from 700 billion in 2017 to 1.2 trillion in 2018 and is expected to worth $3.2 trillion by 2022. So here I have tried to classify it. Try to deliver some of the most important aspects in which AI is dominating. So first is AI assisted surgery that provides better provision. AI is being applied to surgical robotics. Thanks to this data and complex algorithm, AI can determine patterns within surgical procedures to get the best precision, but even better than the teams of doctors. Now coming to second, the world got its first robot citizen. As you must be familiar, this is Sophia, and she is a realistic humanoid robot capable of displaying human-like expressions and interacting with people. It is designed for research education and helps promote public discussion about AI, ethics, and future of robotics. So here is another important aspect of AI, that is AI in medicine. Similar to how doctors are educated through years of medical schooling, doing assignments and practical exams, receiving grades, and learning from mistakes, AI algorithm also must need to be taught to the doctors in medical schools. Not that complex algorithms need to be taught, but yet they need to know some up to a certain level so that they can cope up with the future. At last, I would like to conclude that AI is not a job item. Rather, it would be providing new horizons for growth in particular domain. So now I would like to call Sanskriti to sum everything up and conclude.
To sum up, I would like to conclude through that though the technology has advanced much in the field of humanoid robots, but there are still several problems that need attention. The technological brilliance of these humanoid robots are required to be sharpened more, and the shortcomings in the result of which may be dealt with properly. The field of humanoid robotics is a very promising one, and there is a lot of changes that still needs to be brought in this technology. Thank you all for your patient hearing. I hope you had a wonderful time in our presentation. Thank you.